Hey everybody, today we have a pair of projectors that were sent in. These are both a pair of Optoma TH1060s, if I remember correctly. Let's get that bubble wrap unwrapped. These came very well packed. They didn't come packed together, but they were packed well together. They weren't leaning or pushing or, you know, causing any trouble. I'm not usually a fan of shipping more than one projector in a box, but it is doable. So these were sent in because they suffered from power loss. They are used outside, not exposed outside, but protected outside for Christmas displays and stuff. And apparently last time they were used, they got a little wet. I don't know if that's what that is. I mean, it's, you know, it's still not wet, but those little spots. Or what, really? The owner said that they do get standby lights, but nothing else past that. So, I mean, we're going to investigate potential power supply problems. Probably have to clean them. These have that annoying design where the lamp blower fan is crammed into a little space, like right there on the front. So it's perfect for picking up and holding dust. You know, you can clean it all you want, but if they design it in a not great way, you're kind of stuck. These are nice projectors, though. Hopefully you can hear me over that plastic. I used to run one of these myself as my home projector. It looks like they sourced them from, pardon me, from an e-recycler. Looks like an e-recycler tag there. But they're good projectors. I've always loved the picture on them. So first things first, let's make sure they're safe to turn on. I'll start with the we'll start with the one that I'm going to call the cow projector because it's got the spots all over it. So let's get that little... Let me get a couple tools ready here. Here we are. Let's get that little rubber bit out. Get that loose. And then I have to use this screwdriver. That's right, because these are small screws. I just want to make sure the... lamp assembly is in good shape. Come on. Not have it out all the way. There we are. There we are. It slides that way and then up. Looks like they still have the original lamp inside. 58111167 01. Oh, wait, no, those stay in. I'm trying not to lean in front of the camera. It's making me, well, making me, I'm accidentally almost taking the wrong screws out. There we are. All right, this is an original. This is probably the original. You can see that sticker on the side. That's a Phillips. There's no AM on there, so that's original. Coating's good. It actually doesn't look too bad. The lamp blower fan that I'm talking about is that opening down there. It runs across, and there's a fan like over here. We'll see when we open it up. But this is a good sign. The lamp not looking overly heated or big piles of dust. You know, it just kind of looks all right. So let's put this back on and I'll put the screw back in and then we'll check the other one real quick, and then we'll power them up and see what they're doing when they get powered up. I'm debating if I'm going to fix them both at the same time or maybe split this up into two videos. I think it'll depend on what I find. If they both have the same problem, we'll just barrel through and we'll treat it like one projector twice. By projector. Now this one's a little more crusty. That looks like maybe some water did get in. That lamp is pretty beat, actually. You see that white spot, the tip of my finger right there? That's pretty bad. This really should be changed. I'll bet these have a lot of hours on them. Now with these housings, the bare lamp inside is pretty easy to get. They're well available, 250 watt E21-8. So replacing the bare lamp might be a good option for this projector, because the fellow that owns these, they're used outside, you know, protected, but you know, for an outdoor use. So both lamp assemblies look okay. Let's start with this one, and let me get my power cord. All right, I saw the other lights flash. Green light came on. Green light, slow blink. We get nothing. Flash, fast red flash. Green, slow blink. I don't know if that necessarily means standby. I kind of think it might. But that one's not working. Let's see if this one's doing the same thing. Yep, they flashed. And let's see if this goes to a slow green flash. And then I'm going to go check the manual real quick and see what that means. Glad I checked the manual. Two, three. Two, three, four. It's giving us an error code of four flashes. I can't seem to find that in the manual. This tends to mean error, though, some sort. Let's, remote's not picking up. Let me try it again. I may actually go to the LAN connection and see if I find anything reported back error-wise. A normal standby would be 2 seconds on, 2 seconds off, but this is flashing four times. One, two, three, four. But no other lights, which doesn't seem to be referenced in the owner's manual. I don't think I have the service manual. Let me go double check. All right, no service manual. So let's just... let's just do the easy stuff. I could tie it into the LAN and all that, but I think let's just open it up. Because somebody else already did. Don't remember if the owner told me he was in it or not. He probably was. I kind of blame him. However, that the center screw is missing, which is a problem, because I'm wondering if maybe something got crushed. Yeah, like what the heck am I grinding on there? That's weird. I don't technically need to take those out unless I need to take that whole back panel off, but I think we may end up doing that. These are very similar to the Polyvision PJ905. I've worked on a bunch of those. I don't know if I have the equal amount of videos up on them, because they all kind of had the same problem when I work on them. So I probably only put one or two videos up. But I've worked on a couple hundred of the PJ905s. Lamp housing comes out, and then these two screws. Now, oh, that one fell out good. I'm actually going to move this one for now. Put it on the shelf. Then I'll bring it back up here when it's time. Let's get this cover off. Unplug that. Look at that. I wonder if that's it. I didn't notice if it had a door open problem. But I'll bet you that's the problem. The plastic broke. I wonder how they did that. Let's see. So if that's supposed to sit here, you can see it in there. I wonder if they were trying to push in, maybe? I don't know. But that's how it works. You can see the door goes on, and then that. Like that. I could super glue it. Let's put some glue in there for now. I may just bypass the whole thing and just eliminate that door switch altogether. Let's get our glue here. Get that broken bit out of the way. I put way too much in there, so things it'll probably stick to my fingers and everything. Let's just get that all down. It's tight, so I'm just gonna use the screwdriver to push just to hold that in there. I'm just holding that until the glue sets up. Here we are, the glue's starting to set up. I still think I should probably just drop a blob of solder across that, because this guy only uses these outside, so it's not like we have to really worry about the level of safety with having the lamp door on or not. In fact, let's do this. I want to see if the light blinks differently. So let's bring the projector back into view. We can see that. Let's put the keyboard wire back in. And then while that super glue is setting up, let's put this finger on it. Let's put the door back on. And that is pushing it, so that's good. So let's just set this here. And now I'll get my power cord again. And let's see if we get normal standby LED. On for 2 seconds, off for 2 seconds, that sort of thing. 1,000 to 1,000. Yeah, so that's good. Alright, let me unplug it. Let's drop this in. This one's pretty beat. But I think it'll work enough for our purposes, and for his purposes, for the time being. I will suggest he gets himself a new lamp, though. There we are. And snug these guys down. I think I can leave this in. I might be able to put the cover on with the lamp assembly still installed. A lot of times they catch on the plastic, so you have to take them out. But this is good. It's alright. Just gonna lean it on top there. Power back up. 2 seconds on, 2 seconds off. Oh, hear that? We have fans. We have a light. We should see Optoma in a moment. There it is. There we are. And we have a picture. Oh, and I bumped the door. Oops. I shouldn't have done that. Oh, well. It's all right. The important part is that it came on. So let's take that door off again. And let me look at this. That actually feels really strong. That's not wobbling at all. Let's put it back on. I prefer to repair these all the way. There should be a screw that goes down in there, a long one. Let me actually go find some screws. All right. So I do have a bunch of scrapped PJ905s that have this stuff in them. I grabbed two because I assume the other projector's probably also missing that centerpiece. I'll show you how this goes. Spin it around so you can see. So the center screw hole, standoff, or whatever you want to call it, down in here, that mates with this piece. There's supposed to be a white plastic spacer that helps support the middle. It goes here. Goes down in there. See, that's it right there. That has to be in there. That way, when the top goes on and you put the screw in, you're not pinching down too hard and crushing anything. The other thing I wanted to look at was this fan. That's the fan I always worry about. Seems to be a common failure point, but this one actually looks pretty good. Yeah, the whole thing's pretty clean, actually. Maybe that's why you had it open. But let's put the top cover back on. This is always kind of a pain, this piece right here. Just kind of have to work it so that it goes behind the lenses. Give it a little push. And then we'll put our top screws in. These top two are fine thread. So these are the ones that go here and here. And we can put the door on. Snug that screw down. I'm glad that it was just that door switch. The possibilities were, power supply, keyboard, mainboard, of course. That's, many times a mainboard is kind of the end of things. But in this case, we lucked out. It was just a door switch that had broke loose. I'm wondering now if maybe somewhere else in the manual they talk about that error. I went back to the troubleshooting section and I didn't see anything about that sort of flashing. So it did make me wonder. There's our long screw. There we are. That one's in. And then we have the rest of these. Oh, one thing I do want to show you on the back. These two screws are short. See, the one on the left's maybe a thread or two longer. the longer ones are the actual case screws. The shorter two go into that back panel. These helical screws really do go in quick. You've got a few turns before they lock in. It's kind of nice. All right. Screws are back in. Everything feels snapped. You know, all the plastic bits are feel like they're clicked in. Just move all this stuff over. And now let me get the power cord again, and then we'll fire it up, and then hopefully we're good. I'm curious if this remote works. This remote's for a different model, Optoma. So let's see. Nah. That one? Nah. None of those work. That's fine. But that works. This is an Optoma that's actually made by Delta. Delta makes a lot of projectors, mostly Vivitech, but they make all different kinds. They definitely make a few Optimas that I'm aware of. They just make a lot of projectors. No light. I wonder if it's still cooling down because I bumped the switch last time. So just let it run for a little bit, because that's the cooling down flashing that it's doing now. Half second on, half second off with nothing else. That's cooling down. It's probably because I bumped the door off when we were testing it. So I'll be right back once it fires up. All right, it cooled down. I see Optoma on my hand or something. There we are. Kind of popping up on the screen. Let's see what sort of lifespan this thing has had so far. How many hours are on that lamp? Let's see. Information hide off. Menu. System. You know, for this lamp being as beat as it is, it's pretty dang bright, I gotta say. 1104, it's getting there. I don't know if those are real hours or not, but it's working. Let's see, test pattern. Is that a, no, this one. This doesn't have a test pattern. Oh well, but whatever. It's working. I want to turn this one off, and then let's check the other one and see if it's doing the same thing. So power it down, let it cool down, and I'll be right back with the other one. Oh, this one has it. That's good. I think it did. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, and then 2 in here. Let's get that. Let's get the door off. Then there's those two right here. Now, interestingly, this one still had the centerpiece in it, so I wonder if this one was not open. Inside there, and I do see what looks like the door switch. Not broken. Well, we're about to find out, aren't we? Let's see. So let's give it a little tug. Work my way around. Get it loose. All Okay, that all looks good. Well, let's check it. Let's put the see what the door does. Well, that's what we want to see. Good sign. I do wonder why it was doing that though. Maybe the switch isn't. It seems all right. Just gonna set that there. Get our power cord. One 1000, 2 1000. Keyboard is not responding. Well, let's see if it notices when I disconnect the switch. We get to, yeah. 3, 4, that's right. I wonder if the keyboard's locked on this one. Or if that wasn't tight. Let's do this. Let's switch ends. Let's put the top end on the bottom end on the top, and let's see what we get. So this seems to be acting differently. Connector's a little weird. Let me see if I can hold that tight. Set, no dice. 1000, 2 1000. Nothing. All right, I am going to connect this to the network, and then I'm going to run back to my computer, and let's make sure actually we get LAN first in case we are looking at a power problem. See if those lights wake up. Curious that we're not getting anything there. All right, I'm gonna go check the computer. I'll be right back. Okay, so I got nothing. I went right to my network switch and plugged it in and got nothing. So I think we have a power supply problem in here. Next thing we're gonna do is we're going to get the meter out and start checking some voltages, because remember the rule, thou shall measure voltages. To measure those effectively, we have to get to the low voltage input, which I recall is under here. So let's get these screws out so we can take that metal plate off. Oh, it's awfully warm over here. It's hot almost. These off. I wonder if we have a bad voltage regulator or something. Or this one just might be shot. If it's a mainboard problem, we're not repairing that or replacing the mainboard in this thing. It's a nice projector, but not, well, highly doubt new mainboard projector. This is all really warm. There's some big chips under here that are getting hot, and that makes me a little nervous and a little concerned. But here's our power connector. Right there, we have our 12. Ground and then standby. So it's really not a whole lot to check. I do need to connect this, or I want to connect this. So we had that flash for a split second, so it does make me wonder if this is recoverable. Are you guys can see that I got a good ground. Twelve. 3.3, that's the standby. 3.3. Get a good let me find a good ground. Here's a good ground. Alright, I am going behind it now just to check a few locations on the power supply. There's a chip right here. Oop, it's a bang everything. Alright, so there's a chip back here. This is a PMD1000. That does most of the power management. But boy, these are getting real. Oh, I see something. I don't know if that's water damage or what. I mean, it's definitely more. Oh, that's marker. Dang it, I've got all excited. We got more marker here. Trying to just see if any of these regulators are warm. Not really. Just underneath is really warm. Well, let's pull the main board out and give it a peek. I am losing hope in this one. I'd like to fix both, but if it's going to be one, then it's one. And then he can consider this one a parts unit for that one. You know, it's got a bunch of fans and stuff in it, so, you know, it's not like it's useless by any stretch. It's got a good color wheel in it. So that one has to come out. I think that's it. I think this whole... Oh. I didn't pull these out because I was expecting to find another broken door switch. There we go. These are a real hassle to get out. normally wouldn't do this, except it's an older projector, so back here where this strap, this wire strap goes through, just cut that little thing so we can get that wire loose. See, that wire pulled right out. Let's get that, let me get that ground off. Here's the main board. Nothing obvious. It's all getting really warm though. Let's look at the power supply. Nothing stands out there as a problem. Capacitors look good. I don't see any. I do see some rust, but nothing too awful. Let's see, how painful is that to take apart? I'm kind of hoping that maybe this wasn't plugged in right. Let's get these out. Now we can just separate the main board from the rest of it. A screw here, and then another one. This particular 1060 is not looking good. If we don't find anything very obvious, we're not going to go too nuts, because like I said, it's a good projector, but you know, there's a limit. So I suspect I was feeling heat from these, and that's what makes me nervous. Because if that's bad, really, if that's bad, we're in trouble. This is, well, that actually might have the ROM in it. But I don't see anything obvious. I don't see anything that makes me expect to see an issue. All right, let's try this. Plug that in. Let me put that screw back in. Just want to. I'm going to put the main board in without the bracket and everything so that we can kind of get a raw look at it. And that can go down to there, and that'll go down to there. Okay. So the power, plugs in there. Let's get these up out of the way. That's gonna go in there. Those go in the front. That's out of the way. All so that's down. I am going to put one, maybe even two screws in. I want to secure this so it doesn't pop loose. That. And then let's put another one over here to keep keep it from twisting. So now let's plug color wheel. Color wheel sensor and temperature sensor. There we are. Those are in. Just tuck this over here so it doesn't get in our way. And that one. That one. I'm not worried about the front IR. I am curious about the LAN though, so I will plug that in. Here we are. And then this is just the that stuff on the bottom. I don't care about that right now. All right, that cover, let's get our keyboard. Yeah, it's starting to look like one of these is not going to be reasonable to repair, but we'll determine that in a moment. Just put a screw in here too, just to keep it all from, you know, shifting about. Zoom you guys out a little bit. Oops. Try to keep it straight. All right. Plugged in, and I have the slow flash. Let's see if anything happens. Nothing. It's like something's pulling it low. Yeah, that Pixelworks chip is getting really hot. We're not gonna, it's not gonna get any worse. It's not turning on already, so it's not like it's not gonna turn on worse. So let's see what we can dig out of this here and figure out what's going on. Make sure I have a good ground. Yes, 12. Let's see, what do we have on this pin? Nothing. Going to these buttons. Oh, I just saw that LED flicker. I wonder what that means. See? Let's go to the buttons, maybe. Not that side. That side. All right. So you see that I got 3.2-ish volts, 3.16 to be exact. That's the power button. If I press the power button, it goes to zero. So the keyboard is working, it's reporting back, it's just not listening. So this does appear to have a bad mainboard. let's just check all these regulators and see if anything looks weird. So I got nothing there. 3.3, 1.8. That's probably a 1.8 volt regulator. What do we got here? 1.8, 3.3, 12, 1.5, 1.8. That's ground, of course. We got there. Come on. 5, okay. Man, that's just getting so hot. I think we got a bad Pixelworks chip. I think something, it's really hot. I'm gonna go to some thermal footage. If I can edit this right, because I gotta plug the old thermal camera into this one. So let's switch to that footage now. So look at that. I'm getting about 150 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's see if we can pinpoint that exactly. Oof, yeah, I can feel it. So there's a little bit of parallax issue here, but inside that spot, that's where it is, and that's that Pixelworks chip. That's a problem. Let's see, what else do we have? We have anything else doing that? Let's go from the side. Block that. Ooh, it's hot over here too. Try and hide that so we can see more. Oddly, that one chip is not really doing it. Not really getting that hot. But over here, that's really hot. Man, okay. Well, let's go back to the normal cam. So as you saw on the thermal cam, it's really hot here. It's really hot over here. Do we have anything on these? 3.2. Yeah, it's weird. It's like the voltages are kind of there. Unless they're not supposed to be, 1.8. But let's check a couple basic things. Hopefully I don't block anything. I gotta get new wires. I hate these wires. Oh, yeah, there we are. I got excited for a second. I was like, ooh, short circuit. Probably voltage on it. Let's see if we have voltage on it. No. Huh. There we are. Yep, that's good. Yep, that's all right. So nothing obvious on those diodes. You pop these screws out and we'll take a gander at the bottom side again. But I am moments away from ruling this finished and time for the parts bin. Somebody's parts bin, either the fellow that owns it or me, depending on what he wants to do. I'd be happy to throw it in my parts bin, but it's not my projector. Maybe what we could do is I'll pull out some of the good parts for him, color wheel, fans, that sort of thing, and then we can send it back so he doesn't have to deal with having the projector laying around. All right. Yeah, this is all getting warm, but that was getting really warm. Just trying to see if there's anything obvious. It's just... That's the HDMI chip. Those are the buffers. That does feed over into here. Yeah, things just really hot. This isn't that warm. It's all just getting really hot. Something shorted. I wonder if maybe moisture got under there. See anything that would indicate that, but yeah, I think it's new mainboard time. I'm gonna go take a quick look and see if I can get a used one for, you know, 50 bucks maybe. But if it's really more than that, it's not worth it to repair this projector. As decent as it is, I wouldn't put more than 150, maybe 200, but that's even pushing it. I'd say 150 be about the limit for repairing this. Lamp assembly costs around that, but that's, you know, a consumable. But for any actual repairs, I don't think I'd go over that. So let me go see if one's available, and then we'll wrap this up. All right, so no main board for this. I'm even going to adjust my charge up to $200. I think repairing one of these up to $200 is reasonable. I looked on Fleabay and see these going for anywhere from like 300, 500, 600. I saw somebody asking 850, but they're never going to sell it for 850. It's not remotely worth 850. You'd have to be insane to pay that for one of these. So maybe he'll luck out and get somebody who has no idea what they're doing, but take it from me, do not spend $850 on a 7 to 10 year old used Optoma. If it's a SIM 2, okay, but otherwise, no.